Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Kenny Lammons here with Medicare Millennials, the YouTube channel for Medicare agents. I get just a ton of questions on how to effectively do direct mail campaigns. I've done videos on this in the past, but I just want to go over with you guys as a refresher some of the main things to keep in mind when you're doing direct mail campaigns, okay? I'm going to call this video the top three things to remember about direct mail campaigns before you jump in. These are critical to your success in a direct mail campaign. You can find success doing any type of lead: cold calling, door knocking, Facebook leads, internet generated leads, telemarketed leads. But it's all about understanding that lead source, fine tuning it, and sticking with it. So today's video should help you do that for those of you that want to do direct mailers, okay? So number one, if you are new, and I mean new to the insurance business or new to the niche of insurance that you're going to be doing direct mail to. In other words, if you've been a final expense agent or a health insurance agent, but you've never sold Medicare and now you're wanting to do Medicare direct mail leads, then you're new, okay? So this applies to you. Try to partner first and foremost with an FMO or an upline that has a long-standing track record of doing direct mail so that you can purchase them through the FMO that have a vested interest in you and can kind of help walk you through the process of getting a consistent direct mail campaign going. Okay, and a lot of times they'll also give you discounts or reimbursement programs on those leads. If that's not going to be you, you're working with an FMO that doesn't specialize in direct mail, or they don't offer any, you know, programs to help you with that, that's fine. At least use a mail house, a direct mail vendor that has experience in the niche specifically that you want to work in and builds a plan with you. Okay, so you need to be able to call them and say, look, I'm a prospective customer. I want to buy direct mail leads for the long term. Here's the market I'm on target. Can you help me? What level of confidence do you have in helping me develop a consistent direct mail campaign? And I've used Lead Concepts. I've used ARM. Okay. And both of those are really good options. They're not the only options, but they will walk you through their best practices from their experience in doing direct mail campaigns. So you're not just left out on your own. A lot of you know I've used NeedaLead. I use NeedaLead a lot. And I also go through my FMO a lot. NeedaLead, though, you do your whole entire own lead order, and there's a lot of nuance that you're just not going to know at the beginning. So either partner with an upline, call us, let us know if you need help with your direct mail campaigns, or go with a mail house that is going to be able to walk you through that process. All right, number two, with direct mail leads, patience is king. Okay, number one, they're a slow turnaround. Okay, when you place an order, let's say with a mail vendor like Lead Concepts, you've got a plan in place. It's going to be 2 to 5 weeks from the day you place the order to the day you get the mailer back. They've got to process it, print it, mail it. It's got to get to the people. They've got to fill it out, take their time, go put it in the mailbox. It's got to be mailed back to you and then either sent to you directly or scanned into a CRM so you can view it. So there's a turnaround time. You got to be patient, okay? And here's another thing about patience. It's not just about waiting on the return for one drop. It's about understanding that direct mail returns vary greatly by region, by state, by the lead piece, and by the line of insurance that you're mailing to. So Medicare, annuity, life insurance, etc. It varies greatly where you live, what you're dropping, who you're targeting. So you are going to have the patience to fine tune that. You might start with one lead piece and need to tweak it or ask advice if you should use a different piece entirely. You may mail the entire surrounding area of, let's say, St. Louis, but over time you find XYZ counties and zip codes return well, and then the other half of them don't. And you can only know that through trial and error, or if somebody has worked that area before and they're willing to share it with you. So you have to have the patience to know it's that direct mail is not going to solve your problems overnight. It's going to take a while to get your first drop, and it's going to take a year for you to fine tune the whole process, make it consistent, know where and what you want to mail to, and know the best areas that are going to give you the best return rates for what you're trying to do. OK, Okay. This will not work in short spurts. You can't try it once a year and then say, well, direct mail didn't work for me. It was too expensive. I didn't get the returns. You've got to commit to it. It takes a commitment, and the consistency and commitment over time will ultimately with direct mail lead you to a really fruitful, reliable lead source over time. Okay. So there's a money commitment and a time commitment for you to get what you want from direct mail. Number three is consistency, okay? So it is best to do a weekly mailer drop, okay, through your lead vendor, through your FMO, whoever you're working with on that. Best to do weekly. If budget prohibits, at least try to do bi-weekly if possible. And I mean every week, okay? So let's assume you're gonna be able to do weekly. I still make my drops if I go on vacation. I still make my drops if it's the holidays. Because at the end of the day, direct mail leads do have a really good shelf life. And while we prefer to work them as fresh as possible, if it's 2 or 3 weeks old, it's still a great lead. And so if nothing else, let's say that you mail, work. Then you're off for 2 weeks, like something comes up with the family, you're on vacation, whatever the case may be. You come back after vacation, you've already got 2 weeks worth of leads sitting there. Boom, you can hit the ground running. You got plenty to work. And you just keep going. Or, hey, mess ups happen, right? So let's say your one place you mail doesn't return very well. Well, by being consistent, you still have leads coming in from the last drop, and you're going to be dropping again in a week. So you're going to be able to overcome those dips through the learning curve of finding the long-term return on direct mailers. So never skip a drop unless you just absolutely can't afford it. And one final thing with consistency is at least touch every single lead. I'm big on work focusing on new leads and fresh leads, but I never don't work a lead to some degree. If I have time, if I'm only getting 15 direct mail leads a week, I'll still run through, book how many I can, door knock the others. If I'm getting 50 direct mail leads a week, I may not have time to door knock them all, but I'm gonna at least make sure every single one of them has been double dialed and called, if not door knocked. So be consistent on working your leads, just as consistent you are as you need to be purchasing and placing your lead orders. So look, that might not answer everybody's questions on how to have successful direct mail campaigns, but you know, you can speak to me and Ethan directly, reach out to us on our website, send us an email, and we can set up a phone call if you guys need some more specific help. Have a great, wonderful beginning of spring. And